KUGAN CASSIUS IFL TV, proudly sponsored by Everlast, win Liverpool to formally announce the October 9th show, Smith versus Fowler, but also on the card, great fight between Ted Cheeseman and Troy Williamson. Ted, it weren't probably about 3 weeks ago, a month ago, that was in the gym and we were talking about this fight.
Yeah, obviously we knew it was coming. We didn't know the exact date, but now it's here, so something to look forward to.
Talk to me about what kind of test for you Troy Williamson will bring on October the 9th.
I think for me, in my head mentally, this is my last hurdle at British level to give my chance to try and push on in the sport and go further. So it motivates me a lot more than any other fight. Knowing Troy's a good fighter, obviously he hasn't had none of the tests like me. I don't think he's had a proper gut check yet, but he's unbeaten. He don't want to lose his unbeaten record. He's a tough fighter. He can bang a bit. So it's a good test, but I believe my experience will count in the end.
Obviously, yeah, I've just been talking to Troy Williamson there, and I said level of opponents, he has to kind of concede that the level of opponents that you've had edges who he's been with, similar kind of number of fights, but sometimes it's a little bit of the unknown as well when someone hasn't been in with the types of guys that you have.
Yeah, obviously, listen. You always get a test, and some people in that test they have a shine or they foul. And for me, I hope that he fouls, but you never know, he may shine. But I believe I'm ready for whatever he brings. I don't think there's no bad blood between us. I think it's just more, we're both good fighters, we both know what we want to do, we both know where we want to go, and it's about giving ourselves the best opportunity of doing that. And I'll make sure I'm in unbelievable shape, and mentally and physically, October the 9th. And I believe I'll get the win.
Ted, with this being kind of your second phase at, you know, British title level and this sort of level we're talking about now, is it a case of what you said to me that you want to kind of put a close on that chapter and aim to move up again?
Yeah, obviously before I had my demons, I hit a point where as a young pro, you think you're unbeatable and you never are going to get beat, you know what I mean? And you got that glow and you got that feel around yourself where you think, oh no, there ain't no one who's going to stop me, I can beat anyone, do you know what I mean? And I feel like for a while I had a lot of pressure on me, and I was battling the pressure of myself, putting more pressure on myself because I wanted to prove everyone wrong. But now I feel like I've got that relaxed happiness and confidence back of that, to be honest, I'm ready, and I know as long as I perform, I should deal with Troy Williamson.
We've spoken in the past about, you know, how you at some points in your career just don't believe that people have kind of given you the credit, but I suppose people just have to kind of look at your record since you turned pro and kind of pick the bones out of that, because you can't really grumble. I'm on about from fans' perspective, you've gone in there with who's been put in front of you. Hasn't always gone your way, but the majority of the time it has.
Yeah, definitely. And as I say, I've turned it around. As you said, it's a new chapter, and I just want to hopefully can't look past this fight. But I feel like this is the last hurdle for me at this level. And as long as I am successful on October the 9th, I'll push on and sit and roll the dice and see where I can get to.
Obviously, aside from Smith and Fowler, very interesting fight. I'm sure you'll have an eye on at some point in the night. It's between Kieran Conway and JJ Metcalf.
Yeah. Obviously, I boxed both of them, both good fighters. But I believe I sway to Metcalf, as I think Kieran Conway is young, sort of a lot younger than Metcalf. And obviously, when you're young, you still ain't fully grown. And I think Conway's probably outgrown the light middleweight category, and he's making it, but obviously it's probably tough for him. And I think he looked very flat against Sissoko. And I think, obviously, he's got to take this opportunity against JJ Metcalf, but JJ Metcalf's a proper man, and he knows he can make this weight. He's strong at it, and I believe with a bit of experience he got from the fight with me in the 11 odd rounds, I think he will have that bit of edge against Conway.
Just finally, obviously, you scored a spectacular knockout over Metcalf out in Gibraltar. Are you predicting the same against Williamson?
Do you know what? Listen, it's hard to predict, but I do believe now I've got the ability, boxing and coming forward, whatever way I do, I believe within them 12 rounds, I have the ability to get him out of there. But whether I win points or stoppage, it don't matter as long as I get the win.
Ted, thank you very much for your time. Press conference is going to start shortly. This should be an explosive night on October the 9th.
Yeah, cheers. Thanks, Kush. Sweet, mate.